Hey everyone, today I'm doing a bit of a declutter, and this declutter concerns bags, purses. I do have a reasonably small collection of bags. I'm not a bag hoarder. I have a couple of investment bags that I really use heavily, and I generally go for quite good quality. So my declutter really centers around either the quality not being where I like it, me just not reaching for that particular purse, or the bag being just not practical. I have five that I'm going to let go of. I aim to sell a couple of them. They're really mid-range bags, nothing too fancy, but very usable, and they're still in decent condition, most of them. So let's start. The first bag that I want to move on out of my collection is this bag by Kate Spade from the Saturday collection, which is the more affordable side of Kate Spade. So this one I bought because of its versatility, and indeed it is wonderfully versatile. It is in pretty much perfect condition. There's basically no wear on it. Very, very minor wear on the hardware, and the leather itself doesn't have any issues whatsoever. There's no corner wear, there's no bottom wear, so I think it held up very, very nicely, actually. Longevity is important for me when talking about purses. So this is a satchel style, plain black, very minimal hardware, which I like. I don't love super blingy hardware in sort of this brushed old gold, which is also nice. Bright yellow gold is not my cup of tea most of the time. It has the satchel handles, which are actually quite comfortable, and you can fit it on the crook of your hand. Maybe not over a thick coat, but over a thin coat, a sweater, or a bare arm, no problem whatsoever. The adjustable straps are removable, so you can wear it as a satchel. This has two pockets, front and back. The lining is beige, not very exciting interior, I have to say, but it doesn't have to be. Both sides have identical kind of a magnetic closure pocket. Inside we see it opens in an accordion fashion, quite wide. It's easy to use. It does have a zip closure that is secure, and inside we have a few pockets here, a central non-closure pocket, but given that the bag closes from the top, it's not a big deal, and the third compartment with a zip pocket on the side. There is a little bit of a label sewn in here, just states that it's a Kate Spade Saturday bag. I have to say the quality of the leather is surprisingly nice. There's basically no corner wear whatsoever on the bag, no handle wear. Everything is in reasonably pristine condition. The bag has feet, which is a nice touch because it protects it from scratches and wear. We have the stitching on this particular piece is not bad. It's not perfect though. However, this is me being extremely picky, like I am with bags in general. It is very good quality stitching. Not premium quality, but good quality. The leather itself is soft enough to be very pleasant and supple. It also retains some of the texture that helps to keep it nice and smooth, yet not scratch too easily. So this is the perfect type of leather for everyday bags. They're not so scratchable, but the leather quality is there. So this is actually an excellent quality bag that I would keep. However, I just don't tend to reach for it. It's been sitting in my closet. I've had it for 2 years, and I've not worn it for one of those 2 years. So I think it's time to let go. It's just not getting the wear that it deserves out of me. So it needs to move on out. Next bag, I do have my reservations. I'm not sure if you're familiar with this particular brand, but it is a Parisian brand, I believe. So this little number is in gray. It's a very structured work satchel, which is what I was after, and I wanted it in a gray color because I wanted a cool neutral. The shape is not bad. I like it, and I liked it more when I didn't realize that it kind of tries to look a bit like a Phantom, a bit like a Celine Phantom. And from then, I'm not sure I want to wear it anymore. There is a pocket with some pull-tab closures in the front. The handles are quite comfortable. Again, it's a satchel you wear in your hand, briefcase style, or on the crook of your arm. The hardware is gold, not too bright yellow gold, but a little bit more yellow than I like. It does have this detachable over, this detachable long strap handle, and I prefer it without the handle. I think it looks better without it. The brand is actually called Ségolène Encore. There it is, if you can see it. Ségolène Encore. The interior is nothing impressive. It's beige. It does have a pocket on the inside. It does have a zip closure pocket on the side. It does open in sort of an accordion fashion into a basically perfect square. The sides can be snapped because it does have snap closures. However, once you snap the sides, it's more difficult to get into the bag. So I prefer to leave it unsnapped. It is zippable, so the zipper is secure. It's fine. It works. It ended up in my closet. I tried to make use of it, but it really just, it doesn't feel right for me. The shape is not exactly what I like. I do like the handles and the fact that the hardware is kind of minimal, but at the same time, just the quality of the material is questionable. I don't really like it. The stitching is not bad, but it's not perfect. You can see the piping is not entirely perfect. It's not super, super even. I'm quite mad at myself for keeping this. I should have returned it, but the date had passed and then I forgot. And anyway, now I'm stuck with it. I'm going to try to sell it to somebody who likes structured bags and doesn't mind that it kind of resembles the shape of a phantom. I'm happy to report that this next bag does not have any issues whatsoever with quality. This is an excellent quality control brand. I'm talking about Rebecca Minkoff. Usually their leather is not beyond reproach for me. It's really nice. And their workmanship is remarkable. It's very good for the price. It's extremely price-effective bag. This is a very popular silhouette. It tries to look maybe a bit like Chanel Boy, maybe a bit like a Dior bag. Doesn't bother me. I prefer when bags I buy aren't quoting other designers, but there are only so many shapes that you can come up with. And this is actually a very, very nice piece. It has gold detailing, but this hardware from Rebecca Minkoff is by no means cheaply made at all. It's a hefty, heavy chain, very nice quality, a very, very, very extremely minimal wear, if any at all. I don't really see any wear at all on the hardware. It stayed absolutely pristine, so this gold is not gaudy. It belongs here. It's really good quality, therefore it looks luxe rather than cheap trying to be something it's not. And the detailing is extremely good for Rebecca Minkoff. A nice touch here is the fact that the chain strap is not chain all the way. It has this leather component where it fits the shoulder, and that's lovely because in fact, chains are not the easiest to wear on your shoulders. They dig in, they're not super comfortable. Super soft, nice leather is much nicer on the shoulder when you're wearing a bag. Speaking of the leather quality, this is actually quite lovely. It's very soft, but yet not too soft. It doesn't scratch. It wears exceptionally well. The stitching is immaculate. Everything is done perfectly here. I can't find much fault with the workmanship on this piece. The quilting is nice. It looks like a good quality piece, and it is a good quality piece. It has actually been kept in absolute perfect condition. The cool thing about this piece is the fact that you can unclip the chain handle and leave it as a little clutch bag. It's a perfectly classic little rectangular clutch. It's easy to grab. It will sort of go with anything and everything in terms of cocktail wear. Apart from the chains on the back, we have this little Rebecca Minkoff engraved plate. And in the front, we have a really nice quality little closure here with, again, engraving, very good quality engraving on the bottom. Again, these nice details really add to the feel of the piece. And here we have the closure that switches from vertical to horizontal, thereby revealing the flap. In the back, we have a little pocket. The lining is cute. In Rebecca Minkoff bags, the lining is basically the same as what they include as a duster bag for these purses. So if we open it up, we see a single compartment kind of deal. And really, it's not very big. It has a little hidden pocket here, and it has, again, a leather panel with a brand name. What a lovely little piece. I really, really enjoy it, and I think it's so well made. It makes me happy. So why am I getting rid of it from my collection? The problem with this piece is the fact that it is just too small. Micro minis are so in right now. Everybody has one. Everybody wants one. People go crazy for the tiny bags. And this was going on in the last couple of years. The bags got smaller and smaller. They shrunk. And for me, it seems like they become less and less functional as they get tinier. So this was my attempt to sort of get in on the small bag, and I would have been successful because I actually really like this piece, except apparently I don't like tiny bags. I just don't like them. They fit nothing. They fit a phone and maybe some money, maybe a lipstick, and that's it, which is what an evening bag should be. And if I was keeping this bag for evening wear only, I would be absolutely happy with it. However, I wanted to also get some casual wear out of it, because how many times really are you dressing up for evening wear? Not much. And I wanted to be able to throw it over the shoulder if I'm like off to go somewhere, like shopping or meeting with a friend for brunch. For that, this bag for me is way too small. I like it, basically fits the size of my palm. It's not much. And this way, I mean, it has a little bit of width, but put a phone in it, put a wallet in it, and that's it. You can't really fit much more. For some people, that might be enough. For me, I like to carry the napkins, maybe some wet wipes, maybe some other thing. Maybe a nail polish that I'm wearing today in case of chips happening. I want to be able to sort of correct it right away. You know, there are things that you want in your bag. I always want a hand cream in there. And none of that stuff will fit in here for casual wear, unfortunately. Therefore, this bag is just not worth for me to keep. It takes up a little bit of space, but I'm trying to clean out, and I don't really need it. It comes out to play very infrequently. The next piece I want to talk about is this Mark by Marc Jacobs, sort of a relaxed, slouchy satchel. Kind of a hobo bag and satchel cross. I like that in purses. I enjoy the style that is sort of a crossover. It's not too structured, but it'll pass for a work bag, no problem. This is what I was after with this guy. I got disappointed. I'll tell you why. First of all, the design is actually not bad. There's not much going on in terms of shape. There's a little panel here with some branding, not too out there, so not annoying me. I have to say that the yellow gaudy gold is a turnoff for me. It hasn't worn perfectly. It's starting to fade slightly. The long straps are the long strap is adjustable, and it is removable as well. It doesn't look bad. It looks okay with a long strap. Not my favorite look for this bag, but it's not bad. It does have the little feet that I do enjoy, with some Mark by Marc Jacobs engraving on the bottom here. The wear on this had been not so great, actually. I've only had it under a year, and already we see corner wear. This is quite disappointing. It only seems to have affected that particular corner. Other ones look good, the handles look good, all the corners of the leather around the bag also look pretty good. So here we have the zipper closure. It's quite secure. Again, the yellow gold is really starting to annoy me. I don't like that color in hardware when it's really, really bright yellow and not excellent quality. Inside we have this huge compartment, basically one compartment deal. We have one pocket here, and that's pretty much it. It's a sack. You can fill it however you like. It has tons of space. Another issue with the quality that I had with this particular bag is the fact that just maybe a month into actually wearing it, it started coming apart where the handles meet the lining. This part of the bag should really be quite secure, because that's where the most pressure is exerted by anything you might carry in that bag. Now, this is not the kind of delicate creature I was looking for. I don't carry bricks in my bag. It's quite normal stuff, really. None of the other ones are behaving in such an inappropriate way. This one started coming apart slightly from where the handle is attached. Moreover, it did it on both sides. On this side, it's a little bit less, but you can still see it's starting to come apart. Generally, I was underwhelmed with first the hardware and second the quality of sewing and the lining. The rest of the stitching, the leatherware, is not bad. I have a feeling that they have two different teams doing the leather and the lining kind of sucks and the leather work is okay. The rest of the leather stitching is fine. I don't really have a problem with it. And the leather quality is quite nice. It's sort of grainy, soft leather. The leather, it is very touchable. It is reasonably durable. Not bad overall, but just the hardware and because of the wear and tear inside at the handles where they attach, I was just underwhelmed. I think that was too much money to pay for quality that is kind of this crappy. Shame on you, Mark by Marc Jacobs. It's a good thing you're getting discontinued. By the way, did you hear the line Mark by Marc Jacobs is getting tossed? Now, if you do like that line, now is a good time to buy because most of their models are on sale. I certainly overpaid for this guy. The last bag that I wanted to show you is an absolutely indestructible piece. I'm actually have to say, this is by Michael Kors. It's their tote. I have to say, I don't like bags by Michael Kors. That was the one and only bag I've ever bought by this brand. I generally don't like what they make. So this thing will survive a nuclear explosion, I swear. It's so sturdy. I've had it for 5 years. It is incredibly, incredibly well worn at this point. But it still doesn't look like it's trash material. Here we go. This is the design of it. It's treated Saffiano-like leather, which makes it which means that it's rubberized leather that is made to be incredibly long-lasting. You can see this bag had gone through hell and back, and the corners are still in reasonably good shape. It's shocking, in fact, because I have dragged every hospital floor and lecture hall with this bag, and it's still kicking it. So here we have sort of minimal branding. You have a bit of a gold metal plating here and a little dangly MK, which I don't like but never took off because I'm just lazy. The most wear, I have to say, is really the handles. The handles were put through the ringer. You can see that, in fact, they were. The sort of protective sealant piping on the sides had completely rubbed off in most places where it's actually folded or used very much. It's better closer to the handles, but really the wear off on this is extreme. Although the handles are still working perfectly and had not given way whatsoever. You can see that the piping is gone. However, the fact that they are so securely attached here and hadn't ripped, although I've carried my life in it, it's very, very impressive. Inside we have typical tote sort of compartments. The middle is zippable. It fits my 11-inch MacBook Air, no problem. Again, zippable here. It has a cute feature that I do like in purses, which is this little keychain thing. Basically, you attach your keys or whatever else you want to attach, I guess, but I like attaching my keys to the bag. And then in the dark, for instance, if you're coming home in Canada here, it's dark half the year because it gets dark around 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Therefore, by the time you get home, it's pitch black. So the nice part is that you just graze around and then you pull out your keys right then and there. No problem whatsoever. So yes, very handy. This bag is extremely, extremely usable. But I have other totes now that I like better. I'm not convinced that I'll get rid of it. I'm just kind of sentimentally attached to it. Probably I'll give it to a friend. I don't think it's in a sellable condition given the handle wear. So that's it for today. I hope it was fun for you to listen to some of the reviews, firstly, of the purses that I have and to just see what I'm decluttering, what's going from my collection, what's leaving. That's it for today. Have a good day. See you later. Bye-bye.